anticholinergic drugs, and the treatment of central nervous system diseases is really an amazing topic to talk about. An anticholinergic agent is a substance that blocks the neurotransmitter acetylcholine in the central and peripheral nervous system. Anticholinergics inhibit parasympathetic nerve impulses by selectively blocking the binding of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine to its receptor in nerve cells. Anticholinergics are divided into three categories in accordance with their specific targets in the central and peripheral nervous system: anti-muscarinic agents, ganglionic blockers, and neuromuscular blockers. To talk about pharmacological action, it manages some diseases in the central nervous system, like Parkinson's disease. It restores the balance between dopamine and acetylcholine in the neostriatum. It reduces only tremors and anxiety. So, used as adjuvant therapy with other anti-Parkinson drugs. So, what is Parkinson's disease? It is a progressive disorder of the nervous system that affects movement. It develops gradually, sometimes starting with a noticeable tremor in just one hand, but while a tremor may be the most well-known sign of Parkinson's disease, the disorder is also commonly causes stiffness or slowing of movement. Although Parkinson's disease cannot be cured, medications may improve your symptoms. In occasional cases, your doctor may suggest surgery to regulate certain regions of your brain and improve your symptoms. In the early stages of Parkinson's disease, your face may show little or no expression, or your arms may not swing when you walk. Your speech may become swift. Parkinson's disease worsens as your condition progresses over time. Side effects: dry mouth with possible acceleration of dental caries, blurred vision, also increased intraocular pressure, so it's dangerous for people with narrow angle glaucoma. Also, stopping of sweating, as consequent decreased epidermal serum dissipation leading to warm or red skin, and increased body temperature as a result. Also, increased heart rate and urinary retention and inhibition of the respiratory. It acts as respiratory depressant, and it causes possible effects in the central nervous system, resembles those associated with delirium, confusion and disorientation, euphoria or dysphoria. Finally, the contraindication of anticholinergics is glaucoma, because it increases the intraocular pressure in the eye. Also, prostatic hypertrophy and paralytic ileus. Also, tachycardia, as it increases heart rate, and myasthenia gravis. I'd like to thank you very much for listening to that video, guys.